Hey guys, it's Saya the dog here, and I'm back with another Q&A video. I know, it's a little too soon for a part 3, I mean, I obviously made the part 1 like 6 days ago, and I even made one yesterday, so yes, I know it may be a little too soon for a part 3 since I made one 6 days ago, and I made one yesterday, but unfortunately, I couldn't wait any longer. I just really wanted to answer your questions that y'all asked me. So, I'm just doing another part 3 anyways. Okay, guys? Oh, and by the way, I'm still at my aunt's house, and I'm going back home tomorrow. So, this will be another Q&A at my aunt's house. Okay, no more talk. Let's get into this. Okay, the first question is by Mason Franco. I don't know how you say his last. I'm just gonna say Mason. Anyways, the first question is by Mason, and he asked, "What year did you join YouTube?" Well, the first video on my channel may be from 2016. I actually joined YouTube in 2015. See, it even says it here in my channel description. Joined June 7th, 2015. And I was 7 years old when I joined YouTube. So yeah. I joined YouTube on June 7th, 2015, when I was 7. You see what I did there? But sadly, all of my videos from 2015 are deleted, and some of my videos from 2016 are even deleted. And for those of you who want to know why most of my older videos got deleted, well, there's a few reasons for why most of them got deleted, and I'll tell y'all. Okay, so the reasons why they would get deleted is, alright, here's the first reason. So when I was 7, I was, you know, still, immature and, like, disobedient, would have a bad attitude when I had to do homework, and I cried when I had to go to school in the morning, and I would even have, like, an attitude like that at school, where I would, be disobedient and whiny, and my teacher would have to call my mom, and my mom would be like, "Hey, Sai, I got a call from your teacher at school that you were bad today, so I'm gonna delete your videos." So yeah, that's one of the reasons why most of my older videos got deleted, because when I was being bad, my punishment would have to be that my videos would get deleted. Now y'all are probably thinking, your parents should have cut you some slack because you didn't know what you were doing, you were just a little kid. Well, yeah, while I was just a little kid back then, I still had to have a punishment. Even if most little kids don't know what they're doing because they're still too young, they still need to have punishment. So yeah, that would be my punishment when I was being disobedient. I would get my older videos deleted. So yeah, that's one of the reasons. But there's another reason why. Another reason why I got deleted is because some people were saying mean things to me, and like, yeah, they were leaving hate comments and being rude. Not all people, though, of course. Obviously, there are some people who are still nice and enjoy my videos, and even some people who gave me constructive criticism, you know, like, gave me advice on how to improve, which is good. But my mom wanted to protect me from the haters, so that's another reason why she deleted most of my videos. In order so I would not get any more hate. So yeah, she was like, "Oh, Saya, these people are being mean to you, and I don't want to see my daughter get hate because you don't deserve it. You're such a sweet kid, and you don't deserve this." So yeah, that's also why they got deleted. So I could be protected. But another reason why they got deleted is that these videos would not just get deleted because of my mom, but sometimes I would even delete them myself. Like, sometimes I'd look at them and I wouldn't like them, and I'd get bored with them, and I was like, "Eh, I don't like this one that much," and so I delete it. Yeah, there's the three reasons why my older videos are deleted. When I write, they were either my punishment or so I could be protected, or I just deleted them myself. But yeah, I did not join YouTube in 2016, even though my first video on my channel, which is this one, LPS Pool Fun. I really joined YouTube in 2015 when I was 7. Time for the next question. Okay, this next question is by Cherryville the Fox. She asked three questions. Alright, the first question she asked, what breed are your dogs supposed to be? Okay, Bella is a Yorkie, but her son Ice Cube is a Yorkie mix, and we don't know what he's a mix of. Okay, so here's the story. So in 2018, Bella got out of the house, and then a male dog found her and mated with her, and that's how she had Ice Cube. But we did not see what. We did not see what breed the dog that, mated with her was. Okay, so we know Ice Cube is not 100% Yorkie because he does not really look like one that much, but he is, because Bella is a Yorkie, so is Ice Cube, but he's like a mix of a Yorkie and something else. But again, we did not see who the dog that mated with Bella, we did not see what breed it was. I think Ice Cube might be like a mix of a Yorkie and a Dachshund because he kind of has like the long body of a dachshund. So maybe the dog that mated with Bella was a dachshund and Ice Cube is a Yorkie and dachshund mix. But yeah, basically to answer your question, Bella is a Yorkie and Ice Cube is a Yorkie mix, and we sadly still don't know. But because we don't want Bella to have any more kids, like we already have two dogs, Bella and Ice, and like that's good enough. And because we don't want her to have any more kids, Bella is now fixed, and so is Ice Cube, because we don't want him to get out of the house and mate with another female dog, like what happened to Bella. So yeah, Ice Cube is also fixed. Both of my dogs are fixed, meaning they can't have kids. Ice Cube is a boy, obviously, so he can't have kids, but you know what I mean. He can't make a female dog have kids, is what I mean. And also, I wish Bella and Ice Cube were with me right now, but they're not. The way I say that, I make them sound like they're dead, but don't worry, guys, they're not dead. They're still alive. They're just not with me, because I'm at my aunt's house, and they're back home. They're back home with Mom and Timmy, but I'm gonna see them tomorrow, because I'm going back home tomorrow. Even though Bella and Ice Cube are not with me, my cousin Melanie's dog, Charlie, is. Hey, hi, Charlie. Oh, oh my gosh, look at him. See that he just stood on his little his feet. He's so cute, but he's kind of hyper sometimes. Okay, now that we answered that question, let's see what the next one is. She asked me three questions. I already answered this one, and now the second question. What do you prefer more, Hollywood or indie animation? Well, that depends what we're talking about in this situation. If we're talking about the art, like if we're talking about what Hollywood makes and what indie animators make, then I like both of them. I like most movies and TV shows by they're made by, companies in Hollywood, you know what I mean? Like Disney and DreamWorks, and I like most of their movies and shows, and but I also like shows on YouTube that are for free. But if we're talking about the creators behind the arts, like the artists, then I prefer indie animation creators. Now, here's what I mean by that. So Bollywood is known for having greedy people who make lots of sequels and remakes because they think it'll make them more money. They're selfish. And then nowadays, barely anything. I'm not saying every single modern movie is unoriginal, because there are still original films, but like, a lot of them are sequels and remakes. But as for indie animation, most of them are, original and something that's never been done before. And most indie animators, treat their artists and actors or actresses with respect, unlike, Hollywood, because last year there was the whole writers and animators and actors and actresses on strike and that thing. Now, indie animation creators still have their controversy, and they can be like Hollywood, where they mistreat people they work for, like Rooster Teeth, for example, is an indie animation company, and they are not friendly. They mistreated their animators and a couple times, and I think they even harassed somebody that was transgender, which is horrible. As an LGBT supporter, I feel bad for the trans person, and no, I'm not transgender, but I support people who are transgender. But overall, I prefer both Hollywood and indie animation, but when it comes to indie animation creators, and like I prefer the people that are behind them, because like I said, indie animation's not like Hollywood that much, where they, again, not all the time, but almost most of the time, indie animation creators at least pay their actors and actresses and animators with respect. But Hollywood, not so much. And they cancel almost everything and make stuff that's unoriginal. But yeah, I still like both. I just support like the animation studios, but not like the animation company. Basically, this is a separate the art from the artist situation, if you know what I mean. But okay, next question. How did Pomni from the Amazing Digital Circus have a nightmare if they can't sleep in the digital world? Because she has autism? Okay, next question. Okay, this next question is by Gypso. Gyps of M. I don't know how to say your username, but okay, they asked, what's your opinion on the Puyo game series? I've never heard of that before and I never played it, so I don't know. What's your opinion on the Mario Kart game series? I have not played Mario Kart yet, but I've seen videos of people play, and I think I've even seen my cousins playing it one time, and it seems like a cool game. Third question, what are your favorite Puyo characters? Well, I still haven't played it yet, and also, I haven't heard of it yet, so I don't know what my favorite characters are yet. I don't even know any of their names. All right, then the last question they asked was, what are your favorite Mario Kart characters? Oh, it's simple. It's Peaches, 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 Peaches. I'm sorry, I had to. Oh, but it's not just Princess Peach, it's also Mario, Luigi, and a Donkey Kong too. Sorry. Okay, I'll stop. I'll stop. Okay, next question. All right, these questions are by Ninjago Fan 2023, and the first question is, what's your opinion on Spider-Head 2022? I haven't seen it yet, so I don't know. And the second question he asked was, what's your opinion on A Good Day to Die Hard? I also have not seen it yet. I have not even seen the original Die Hard movie anyways. And I never watched any of the Die Hard movies. But yeah, I don't know what my opinion on A Good Day to Die Hard is because I haven't seen it yet. But next question. All right, next question. The next questions are by Mary the Husky Gal, and she asked, the first question is, have you seen the Bluey episode, The Sign? I have seen this episode before, and it's bittersweet for various reasons. Because it's kind of like the last Bluey episode. And also where the Healer family moves out of their house, and Rad and Frisky, I think that's their name, where Rad and Frisky also finally get married, and then Bluey grows up in the end and has a kid. It's a great episode. And the second question she asked was, what is your zodiac sign? Since I was born January 21st, my zodiac sign is Aquarius. It says it here on Google, the zodiac sign for January 21st is Aquarius. And the third question she asked was, do you still like Animesh even though it has weird and problematic people? Yes, I do. And for those of you who don't know what an Animesh is, it's basically, like a music video with various animated movies and TV shows while a song plays in the background. These were very popular in the late 2000s and the early 2010s. I don't know if people still make them, but even if it may have weird and problematic people, yes, I still like these types of videos where with like animated movies and shows put together while a song plays in the background. And it's been forever since I've made an Animesh. I think I'm I'm thinking of making another one someday, but I don't know when. Anyways.
Next question's by Dejana Rocks, and she asked, what is your favorite season?
I don't know, that's a hard one. I think my favorite season's probably winter. I don't know why. Maybe because winter's in January and January's my birthday. And maybe also because it's Christmas in winter too, because you know it's in December and December is. And yeah, winter is in December. I have no idea why winter is my favorite season. Sometimes my favorite season is also fall, cause the leaves change color and they're not always just green anymore. They're different colors, like yellow, orange, red. Okay, you know what's weird? I don't have a favorite season. I like all seasons, okay? I love all of them equally, and I don't have a favorite one. But next question.
Also, the last question. This is by Rider Ninja, and he asked, what was the best crossover idea I have ever made on my channel?
It's really hard to say because you have a lot of good ones, but I think my favorite one would probably have to be Monty from Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach and N from Murder Jones as a duo. That and another one I like would probably have to be Rocky from Lackadaisy and Zen from Kung Fu Panda 4 as a couple. The cat and a fox is a pretty interesting couple, if you ask me. Okay, guys, well, that's it for this video. Those are all the questions that I had to answer. I hope y'all enjoyed, and if y'all want a part 4, then you can ask me more questions in the comments below if you want. And I might even make part 4 while I'm here. At my aunt's house or tomorrow, I don't know. I'll do it when I feel like it. But yeah, that's it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all real soon. Bye.